Atlantoaxial rotatory subluxation is when the first and second cervical vertebrae don't line up and stay in place with each other. We share about how difficult it was to treat a 10-year-old boy who kept having torticollis. Using an open-mouth odontoid radiograph and a CT scan, a doctor was able to make a diagnosis of atlantoaxial rotatory subluxation. The child was taken to the hospital a lot for continuous halter traction in the first 6 months after the symptoms started. He also had a short-term problem because he overcorrected when correcting his neck bracing. This case was discussed by a multidisciplinary spine team and sent to a chiropractor's clinic 7 months later. In spite of the fact that the child had atlantoaxial instability on the radiographs, after 5 months of chiropractic treatment, he didn't have any symptoms and had almost full range of neck movement. This was also the case for him. He stopped taking acetaminophen, which he had been taking for the last year. At the follow-up after treatment, gynecomastia on both sides was found. There was a chance discovery of innocent gynecomastia, even though it is common in preteen boys. This raises the question of how acetaminophen affects the regulation of sexual hormones, which was previously overlooked, even though it is common. The current study is indexed at the United States National Library of Medicine at the National Institutes of Health maintain the database as part of the system of information.